It is nearing the end of maple syrup season in the Midwest. And News 19's Danny Smith, along with photographer Travis Udall, visited a local farm to see how the sweet treat goes from tree to table.
Located in the heart of the Driftless region, B&E's Trees got started 9 years ago. When couple Bree and Eric decided to tap a maple tree in their backyard.
Bree and I wanted to figure out how we could make a life out of our love for playing outside and working in the woods.
But the couple's hobby quickly turned into something more.
We decided to start a maple syrup farm because it was the combination of all the things that we love to do.
Since then, the two purchased 184 acres of land in Cashton with more than 4,000 taps. B&E's now sells their syrup across the Midwest, from Madison to Milwaukee, even Chicago and the Twin Cities.
Being able to make a living doing what we love, being involved with the land, being involved with the woods, has really been a dream.
But it hasn't always been a walk through the woods.
Maple syrup is extremely weather dependent. We have had seasons that are almost 2 months long. Our very first season was only 9 days.
We really need those nighttime freezes and then the warming up during the day. And that causes the sap to go from the roots all the way up to the developing buds that are trying to turn into leaves in the tops of the trees.
Sap collected from the trees is then brought to this place called the Sugar House, where 40 gallons of sap is then boiled down to 1 gallon of maple syrup.
So this is where we take the sap and cook it down into syrup.
It's a craft that takes patience. The boiling down process can range anywhere from just a few hours to all day long, depending on the sap sugar content.
So it's a quite intensive process just to collect that much sap in order to get even just a very, very small amount of maple syrup.
And even an outdoor industry like maple syruping has been impacted by the pandemic.
Over the past year, the majority of our sales dropped off, and so we had to figure out different ways of meeting people so that we could get the income to support our farm.
One of those ways is expanding their product line to add something unexpected, an energy gel made from maple syrup.
That kind of gave us the motivation and the opportunity to really focus in on bringing this thing that we were enjoying to more people and being able to connect the place that we love with the people in the places that they love.
Another way they're staying connected to customers is through their Adopt a Tree program. Customers who enroll get a metal plaque hung from their tree and coordinates to where it stands on the farm.
It's been a really fun way to connect with people. And so when we're out here working in the woods, even though we're working alone, we still know that there's all of these people that are supporting us, and that feels really good.
Keeping connected with customers and customers connected with the world around them.
A little bit of what we're doing here can go into their lives and hopefully help energize them to do good things.
Good that spreads from support that means a lot for a small, family-run business like B&E's Trees. In Cashton, Danny Smith, News 19.
Fascinating process. And B&E's energy gels you saw there come in several flavors. They'll be available in early June, but you can pre-order them right now, they say, on their website, a link to which we'll have on WXW.com as well.